In this video, we'll be discussing the ROS formation in mitochondria and how these reactive oxygen species are neutralized. We see ROS gets generated in the matrix of mitochondria during the electron transport chain. In this diagram, we can see the inner mitochondrial membrane. It's having nicotine amide nucleotide transhydrogenase enzyme. Then there are components of electron transport chain. Like in the inner mitochondrial membrane, we have complex 1, complex 2. Complex 2 is not shown here. Then there is complex 3 and complex 4. Now let's see in detail how these ROS are generated in the mitochondria. During electron transport chain, there is a flow of electrons within the inner mitochondrial membrane through complexes. And in between complex 1 and complex 3, there exists a Q cycle, which receives the electrons and passes these electrons from complex 1 to complex 3. Here in this diagram, we can see the Q cycle. Precisely, we can see the ROS formation takes place during the transfer of electrons from QH2, that's dihydroquinone, to complex 3. Or ROS is generated during the transfer from complex 1-2 to QH2. So basically, it is during the Q cycle we get the reactive oxygen species, which is having extra electron in its structure. Here in this diagram, we see the formation of UV semiquinone in Q cycle. This is a radical molecule and it gets spontaneously converted into stable ubiquinone. But when the rate of electron entry into the respiratory chain and the rate of electron transfer through the chain are mismatched, superoxide radical production increases at complex 1 and complex 3. As the partially reduced ubiquinone radical Q2 donates an electron to the O2, as shown in the diagram. The superoxide can further form highly reactive hydroxyl free radical through Pantone's reaction. On the other hand, the defensive mechanism comes into play. The superoxide dismutase acts on oxygen free radical and converts it into hydrogen peroxide. And then we see reduced glutathione GSH donates electrons for the reduction of H2O2 by the action of glutathione peroxidase. And in that reaction, we get the oxidized form of glutathione, that's GSSG. Now the cell needs to reduce the glutathione back, and for this we have NADPH, which donates its electrons and reduces the glutathione into GSH, a reduced form, in presence of glutathione reductase enzyme. And in that, we get the oxidized NADP+. Furthermore, the oxidized form of NADP+ is reduced back to NADPH by the nicotine amide nucleotide transhydrogenase enzyme, which is already present in the inner mitochondrial membrane. Then we have another defensive mechanism where proteins or enzymes are kept in a reduced state. We see the reduced form of glutathione gets oxidized into GSSG, and in that, it reduces the oxidized cis residues of proteins and enzymes, thus acting as a defensive mechanism against oxidative stress. So this is how ROS are generated and then neutralized too in the defensive process. I hope you like the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Do consider supporting my work on Patreon and also make sure to subscribe this channel. Thanks.